guys, what is up and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, hello. My name is Katie. I live in sunny Florida, Orlando more specifically, and I make Shop With Me videos. Pretty much anything to do with like home decor, stores where you can buy home decor. I just like to go shopping and show you everything I bought in haul videos. So if you love anything to do with like Target, Home Goods, Marshalls, TJ Maxx, IKEA, stores like that, definitely make sure you give this video a big thumbs up and make sure you hit the subscribe button down below. Today's video is a TJ Maxx Shop With Me. In Orlando, like more where I live, we don't have like a lot of dedicated TJ Maxx stores, so I don't do a lot of these videos. So on the days when I'm in a different part of town, I like to try to go out of my way to do a TJ Maxx Shop With Me. So if you are interested in seeing everything that is new this week at TJ Maxx, you will definitely want to stay tuned. I don't want to blab on too much in the intro because I'm super excited to get in there. By the time you are seeing this, we have officially moved into our new apartment. So I'm going to be shopping today for a lot of last minute things. I decided that I don't like the color of our sheets, so I'm looking for new pillowcases. I don't care as much about changing the sheet because it's covered anyways. So I'm looking for a lot of throw pillows, king like shams or euro shams, new pillowcases, and then I also need like a coffee table book and then a bunch of little like vases and stuff just to kind of stick everywhere. I'm just kind of like nervous that we don't have enough decor. I'm also looking for nightstands. So definitely on the hunt for tons of different things. So let's go ahead and head inside and see what we can find today.
Right in the front, they have three of these little like beverage coolers. This one is like a Corona one and then a Coca-Cola one. And then this one's black and just says cold drinks. It's really nice. It's like an insulated cooler and it is $120. It's kind of hard to see that it says cold drinks, but it also has a little like beer top, like beer bottle opener. And then the little tabs fall right in there. This is super nice. I really like this. I think it'd be really cool for our balcony. So right when you walk in, I came in over there, they have like this little furniture setup. I'm hoping that they have more than this, but they have these really cool lamps right here. They're definitely like desk lamps, but they have organizers in the bottom. It also has like a USB port, a full outlet, and just different like spaces to put stuff. They have a black one. They have a white one with gold. I think this is just really cool for like different desk organization, so I wanted to show it to you guys. Okay, I just found these. They are 100 each, and I think I'm in love. The wood is not like a solid color. It's definitely like mango wood, but it has this really cool marble slab on the top, and it does have these like black square little knobs. It has a really nice drawer that slides in and out and then also has like the shelf underneath. I really like these, but I'm not sure if they look like too rustic because of the way the wood is. I do think that the knobs and the top give it like a really modern feel that kind of like tie it together, but I'm not sure. They are $99 each and I think that they're really nice. They seem like really good quality. I sent a picture to Brian. I'm just not 100% sure. But these could be winners. Okay, so like I said, I'm trying to get a lot of like little decor things. One thing I kind of want to try to build in the store is a nice decorative tray for the center of our island. Hoping to have like maybe a wooden tray with a fake plant, maybe a book, a little sign. I'm not sure yet. So that's something I'm going to try to build while in the store, and definitely stay tuned to the end for a haul. Before we get to that, they do have this whole like cleaning section. Couple things caught my eye. This stainless steel cleaning and polishing cloth. I'm obsessed with like keeping my little fridge clean, and it is stainless steel, and I find it to be really difficult, and this is the brand of cleaner that I have, so I'm gonna try this cloth. They have the cloth here for $3.99, so I'm definitely gonna give it a shot. This is another thing I'm gonna grab for $1.99. I just feel like it's a good thing to have around, especially because we're moving into a brand new unit. There could be leftover adhesive, and for $1.99, I feel like we'll be glad we have this. We also do have a glass shower, so I'm probably gonna pick up this. These microwave and cooktop wipes, I struggle so much with cleaning the top of our oven, so I'm gonna go ahead and give these a shot. This is also enticing me. They just have a lot of interesting like cleaning products that I haven't seen before, so they're pretty cheap and I feel like I'll be glad I have them. I have a lot of different like wooden trays here, and like I said, I want to create one for the middle of our island. So I did find this one and I've kind of started putting like little things on there, but I really like the wood of it. I like that it has a little lip and I think it's a good size for our counter, and this is only $12.99, so I'm definitely a big fan. I was thinking maybe like some coasters on it. I'm trying to put it together exactly how I would in our apartment, maybe like a fake plant and a sign like I said, but this is kind of what I was thinking. And I was kind of looking at some of the coasters that they have here, like different options and stuff. And I like these ones because they are marble, but they also have like that wood detailing that kind of like ties it in. And you do get four of them for $7.99. So I feel like it's a pretty good deal. Not dead set on these ones. Like I said, stay tuned to the end to see what I actually end up purchasing. But I think that I could maybe make these ones look really nice. Something like this could also be cute. We don't have one of these yet, like a little mortar and pestle. But I probably wouldn't want to do a wood one on a wood tray. This is where I could tie in the marble again. And they normally have these here, so I'll definitely be on the hunt for one. But this is another like cute thing that I could put on here. And this is also a good place for me to be able to integrate like some seasonal decor, like adding a little bunny for the Easter time, or like changing out a fake plant for more colorful flowers for the spring and summer, that sort of thing. I just found these trays too. These are nice. I like that they have like the handles on the side. I don't really like love the tone of wood. It's really cool toned, whereas we're trying to go for more like warm toned stuff. So these are another option, but I don't think it would work for us. I just found this one. Is this like a chip and dip thing? Because this pineapple is stuck to it and I tried to like pull it off at first, like thinking like what a cute candy dish, I need it. But this is like a little boat and it has that. You could put like little candies in there. This is $16.99, but this is a really, really cute chip and dip thing. We already have so many like chip and dip vessels. Some of them I need to get rid of because I just like kept our old ones because I didn't want to bring our new ones into our temporary apartment. So I'm like, can I get this one? Stay tuned. A little sign like one of these could be cute for the little tray that I want to build. This one would be fun. It says, welcome to adulthood, you have a favorite spatula now, which is so true. But I would want one that you can read from all sides, if that makes sense. That way it's not like a front and back to the tray. I kind of want it to be like a 360 type deal. And they do have these like little blocks that have sayings on every side. This one is all stuff about coffee. So I just need to really like sift through here and see what I can find. Also, these like little books could work as well. They just look like little books, but I just like don't really want them to say anything on them because they have ones like this, like with faith all things are possible, and I love the way that they look, but I just don't really want anything that has like words on it that looks like a book. A little like canister like this could be nice. I don't really want a white one. I kind of want a clear one. I'm just not really seeing any clear ones that I love. I would like one with like a wooden lid or some sort of differentiating factor like that. Okay, now we're getting somewhere. I like this clear little olive oil bottle that has a little cork on top. That could be really pretty. We could actually put olive oil in there and truly use it. It doesn't have to just be for decor. Salt and pepper shakers are another thing I could add on here to make it a little bit more functional. If these ones were gold, that would be so perfect. But unfortunately, they're very, very silver, which just doesn't really go with the look I want to do. And they are $9.99. They're super pretty. If they were gold, that would be ideal. I'm just playing with a million different options right now, but I wanted to show you like an example of something you could throw in here for the summer. So here's some lemons to me, super summery. Let me take this one off. And then this just fits so perfectly right here. And then obviously it wouldn't be this cluttered, but it just fits perfect and it would be like a great summery addition. So I just feel like this is a very versatile tray. Okay, so this is like kind of where I landed so far. I really like adding the texture on here. And then I decided to go with the marble mortar and pestle because I think the wood one just blends a little bit too much. I just grabbed like a little neutral candle, the coasters. I'm gonna layer a plant on top. Still not 100% sure if I want this one, just because these are so similar and I think I want it to be a little bit different, but I do really like the base of this one, like the legs and the texture. This is like kind of where we're at, but I do like that you can add like any of this seasonal stuff and easily integrate it onto here. So this is very interchangeable. Another thing I'm really loving too are these like drapey plants. So we have this really cool like bookshelf. It's like built-in bookshelf, and I was thinking maybe for the top one do like a plant like this where it like drapes down over the other ones as well. I don't know though, it might like get annoying to have it in the way. What do you guys think? Let me know down below. Found this little wooden thing behind this mirror, which could be a really cool addition to my basket wall. It's massive, which helps a lot because I have a lot of space to cover. And it is $49.99. I really do like the shape of it. I haven't seen anything else like this. And I feel like on Etsy, this would be like a lot more expensive. It is made in India. This is really, really nice. Kind of taking a break from this just because it doesn't really have to be set in stone, but I feel like I did find some really good pieces for it. I guess these bud vases are just the thing this year. They are everywhere. They have so many different like styles, colors. They have this like round black one that's really cool for $14.99, and then all like smaller ones similar to the ones that they had in the Target dollar spot, and these are $7.99, so definitely cheaper if you found them in the Target dollar spot. They have endless options for like over the door hangers, little like suction cup baskets, but the over the door hanger thing is making me so mad because I bought one at Target like a few months ago, and I definitely wish I would have come here. I like literally didn't even think of it. I don't even know how, but they have so many more options here for like colors and how many different hooks they have and different like style of hooks. I should have come here. They have these really pretty like plant stands, perfect, three different ones, and they move together like super easily if you like don't have three plants on it. But this is really pretty and decorative, and it is only $29.99. some really nice kitchen towel options. I really like these plain ones. I might go ahead and pick them up. It looks like you get three for $9.99, and I like the look of them. I think that they will go with this other one that I have in mind to use in the kitchen. But now it's just kind of a race to the finish. I finally get to buy all the little finishing touches. I don't want to talk too much about Ray Dunn, but I'm just shocked at like, I definitely think it's going out in my area. It was really big a couple years ago, and now stuff that you would never ever find, you're finding, like this bunny treats canister with like the bunny head. This one that says Easter candy, whatever that is, giant one, another Easter canister. Up at the front of the store, I saw a pot of gold canister, like the skinny canister. So definitely a ton of stuff. I think it's going out here, so if you're just getting into Ray Dunn, I would come to Orlando. Take a trip to Orlando, go to Disney, Ray Dunn hunt while you're here, because you'll find a lot of really, really good stuff that might be really hard to find in your area because the collectors are a bit newer. Practically no selection of pillows, which I'm a bit disappointed in because I really want to get some, but I can just head to another store. But they just don't really have that many pillows, and a lot of the ones they do have are like crazy decorative, and I'm just looking for more neutrals. Same thing for the rest of bedding. This is all they have, and I am trying to find some like pillowcases and stuff, but I might have to go to a Home Goods for that. Every single like TJ Maxx, Home Goods, that sort of thing, like carry more of different stuff. I feel like this one is very like clothing heavy, and TJ Maxx's have a little bit of everything, where obviously like if you're looking for Home Goods specific stuff, I would check Home Goods. But I'm really excited about a lot of the stuff I found here today, and I can't wait to show you what I got. I'm also looking for a little like toilet brush cleaner. This is something I definitely want to pick up. If you remember a couple videos back, I bought a shampoo and conditioner bottle for our guest bathroom. So I'm trying to find the toilet brush cleaner and the soap dispenser that go with it, because I want everything in there to match. So I'm definitely going to be heading to a Home Goods to check there as well. I do like this little setup with the tray, the soap dispenser, and the little like toothbrush holder. This could work too, and it does have like the gray mixed in. I really like this. It just has like the little trays, and it comes in here. They just kind of sit perfectly in there. I did already kind of buy something like this though, so I'm not exactly sure what you would use this for. It's too big for like sauces, I feel like, but this would be perfect for Brian and I for like sauces when we eat dinner. We use like a lot of ketchup, honey mustard, barbecue sauce, Polynesian sauce from Chick-fil-A. So this could work really well for that, or for like dips and then a separate bowl with chips. Or my favorite use for everything, two little candy dishes. These are a great deal if you're just looking for a set for guests. For $20, you get two bath towels, two hand towels, and two washcloths. I have a bunch of different colors here on the checkout. I haven't seen these before, so I wanted to show them to you. Okay, as promised, here is a haul. I spent like $118 total, but I feel like I got a lot of really, really good stuff. Some stuff that Brian thinks it all looks really good. I'm just so excited to move and get everything settled. I'm so excited to show you guys. But let's get into everything I got today at TJ Maxx. Also, let me know down below, like, which one is your favorite? Do you like Home Goods, TJ Maxx, or Marshall's the best? I guess if I had to choose one, I would pick Home Goods just because it has like the most home decor, and that's like my favorite part about them, is the really affordable and trendy home decor. But Marshall's and TJ Maxx are like a more condensed version, so I really like that too. But if I had to pick one, I would definitely pick Home Goods. But let me know which one is your favorite down below. Okay, I'm gonna start with like the bigger stuff, just kind of go like bag by bag. Hi. Oh my gosh.
Okay, sorry. My best friend at home had twin baby girls and they're in the NICU, so she was just calling to update me. But anyways, back into the haul. So the first thing that I got was the marble mortar and pestle. I decided to go with the marble one. The wood one just blends it in too much, and then I just thought, like, realistically, like, if I was using it to make guacamole, what would be easier to clean? And the wood is a lot more porous, and I feel like eventually I would have to toss it. So just in terms of, like, using it or, like, thinking practically, I decided to go with the marble one. And I just really like the way the marble one looked. This was $7.99. The wood one was $13. The price wasn't really a factor. I just kind of went based off of, like, what I thought looked better visually and practically. So I decided to go with the marble one. Okay, and then I couldn't not get the little, like, chip and dip pineapple gold wooden tray thing. This was $16.99. I wasn't gonna get it, and then I sent a picture to Brian right at the last second, and he said it was a must get, which he never says about anything on my shopping trips pretty much. So I knew I had to get it as an ode to just us. You know us, pineapples are our thing. And then for $12.99, I did get that big, like, wood tray that I'm gonna use to decorate my kitchen island. This big tray was only $12.99. I'm obsessed with it. It is nice and heavy, and it's just a super nice, like, great colored tray. Looking at it now, I do think it might be cracked down the middle, but I think it's fine. Okay, and then the next bag I grabbed had, like, the cleaning stuff. So I did decide to get the Magic Shower Glass and Mirror Cleaner. Leaves a streak-free shine and removes soap scum, because our guest bathroom shower will actually have glass, but not our shower. It is what it is. Then I got the microfiber fridge stainless steel cleaning cloth, because I always struggle so hard to, like, not get the streaks on the fridge. So I'm hoping that that will help, because, like I said, it's the same brand as the cleaner I use. Then I got the Perfect Cooktop glass cooktop cleaner and the microwave and cooktop wipes. Hopefully these help with the issue of, like, cleaning the electric top oven. I grew up in the Northeast. Everyone has gas. So when I moved to Florida, I was, like, shocked to see, like, the glass cooktops. I do think that they look really nice as long as you keep them clean, but it's really hard to keep them clean once they get stains on them. So I'm hoping that this will alleviate that problem. These were super cheap. Everything was, like, $3.99 and $2.99. So if you're looking for, like, any specific cleaning products, TJ Maxx might be a good place to go. And I did also grab the Goo Gone as well, because, like I said, we are moving into a new unit and there could be some adhesive or something stuck to the countertop. So I just figure that's a good thing to have, so that, like, tomorrow night or late at night when we are, like, getting settled, I don't have to run to Walmart to get it, because some, like, sticky adhesive would absolutely drive me crazy. So this is just a good thing to have. Okay, next up, I got these towels, three towels for $9.99. They're, like, the nice, like, cottony, like, waffle textured ones. I love these, and they are, like, they have, like, some gold, like, woven into them, or, like, ivory colored stitching with, like, little polka dots. So just thought they were nice. I have a kitchen towel addiction, and I, like, threw a lot of them away in our move, so I wanted to pick up some new ones. Then I picked up a nice little candle. This is just going to be decorative. I'm not going to allow Brian to burn it, because I just want to keep it on our kitchen tray, and I just liked how neutral it was. It says White Magnolia, and it just smells good. It's like a sensational one, just like the look of it. So this is just a decorative candle, and this was $6.99. Then I did decide to pick up those marble coasters, but I might actually decide to use my Hearth and Hand rattan coasters on the tray, because I really like the texture that it might add, and then I can use these on the coffee table. But you can honestly never have enough coasters, in my opinion. The next thing I grabbed was this, like, olive oil jar. I went back and looked to see if they had maybe a balsamic vinegar one. Definitely gonna keep my eyes peeled to see if it comes in that and not just olive oil, because I think it'd be cool to have both of them, and we use both of those things a lot. We love to eat, like, oil and vinegar with, like, fresh bread from the farmer's market. It's, like, one of our favorite hobbies. So I definitely want to see if I can find, like, the balsamic vinegar counterpart that might go with this. Okay, and then I got a couple different, like, fake plants. I did get this one that had the little woven. I'm not sure if I'm gonna use it on the tray, but I knew I could find somewhere to use it, so I wanted to go ahead and pick this up, and it was $6.99. Then I got this one that I think I'm gonna use on the tray. I just loved, like, the little legs on it and the texture, and I like the little plant of it as well. It does appear to be coming out of the little mossy bottom, so I might go ahead and, like, gorilla glue that back in just so it's super secure. But I really like the look of this one too, and this one was also $6.99. And then I don't want to, like, take the whole thing out, but I did decide to pick up one of those, like, drapey plants. I got the gray vased one, and then it will drape down. Not exactly sure what I'm gonna use yet. I have a couple different ideas of places that I might want to use it, but that is everything I picked up today at TJ Maxx. Like I said, I spent, like, $118, and I feel like I got a lot of really, really awesome stuff. Definitely let me know down below what was your favorite thing that I got today. Mine was probably, I love the olive oil thing. I'm super obsessed with that. And I like the whole idea of like the tray. I'm really excited to see it all come together. Alrighty, you guys, well that is gonna be it for me today. I really hope that you love seeing everything that I found today at TJ Maxx. If you love this video, definitely make sure you give it a big thumbs up. Make sure you hit the subscribe button down below if you haven't, to join my little internet family. And I will see you next time. Bye, guys.